Hey, High Levelers. In this video, I'm going to quickly go over conversation AI, the quick and down dirty setup, and when you should use the conversation AI base setup or the workflow setup on that. So let's get started and let's hop right into it here. Okay, so here inside of this, we're dealing with one of my demo accounts. It's an HVAC company, Fresh Flow HVAC. It's a demo account, and what we're going to do is we're going to come over to settings, and then we're going to come into the conversation AI area. Now, this right here is the core or the base AI system that the GoHighlevel platform has developed, and it has three modes. You can turn it off, which is not really a mode to me, but anyway, you can turn it off and just have it not operational whatsoever. You can put it into suggestive mode, and then you can put it into autopilot mode. So if you take a look here, suggestive mode and then autopilot mode. Now, personally, I prefer autopilot mode on things, because then that way when you program and you teach the AI all about the business, then it can respond automatically to multiple different channels. So speaking of channels, let's hop in and take a quick look at which ones are supported. So here, if we take a look at the drop-down list, we've got SMS already selected, but we have some other ones as well. Instagram, Facebook. So let's just say we want that one, Facebook. Excuse me, we just want to add them all. So we want all of these channels, which just basically means that any customer or any person communicating with us on these channels will have the AI system automatically respond back to them if it's set for autopilot mode. Now, if it's not, if it's set for suggestive mode, I'll show you what that looks like. But I personally don't really find that very useful. But right now, every time you make a change, you do have to come in and click save. But right now, let's go ahead and take a look at what suggestive mode means. So I'm going to click on suggestive and click save. Now, what this means is it's going to suggest things that you can say when communicating with the client, but it still requires manual intervention. So it's not really, it's like an AI helper of helping you write stuff, but it's not really helping you respond automatically to customers. So you're not really saving time, because it does require a person to go in and send this data. So if we go back to the context area, so here, if we just pick somebody here, pick this particular person, if we click down here in this area for the SMS, I'm sorry, not that one here. So notice right here that it says AI bot is thinking. So right now, whenever we're doing that here, this is the suggestive mode. So notice that it read the conversation from the particular person. I think this one is, I'm looking for a filter change, I want help, something like that. So now what it's doing is down here in the live chat area, it's actually giving you some suggestions. So if you highlight over it, hey, sure, what's on your mind? Hey there, you just notice down here, this is the suggestive mode. So it gives you some suggestions. And if you want to, you can click on the suggestion, which keeps the text in the box. And then if you wanted to, you can come here and edit, delete whatever you want, and then send whatever you particularly prefer. So hopefully that is, you can understand how you would use that. But again, this works on the desktop version. Just keep in mind that it does require manual intervention. Again, I'm not a big fan of this. I'm not crazy about it. But right now, what I like to do is go into this and go to Conversation AI and go to Autopilot Mode. Now, when we go to Autopilot Mode, this means that AI is going to be responding automatically. When that happens, you have to make sure you train the AI system first. So do not switch into Autopilot Mode until after you train it and you've tested the bot. Okay, now in this particular case, I've already gone through this particular part, so I'm going to go ahead and do this. But right now, if you take a look at these tabs right here, there's a bot trial and a bot training. We're going to go to the training first and then come back to the trial. But if you go to the bot training, what this can do is it can either go out to your website or it can go to something like a Google document, read it, and just think of it as like a big FAQ, a frequently asked questions. You have a bunch of questions and answers for those questions, and then that helps the AI bot learn about your business based upon the information on your website or the information in like a document, a Google document or an FAQ or something like that that you would have. Now, if you take a look here, notice that we do have, it did go to the website here. This is the Fresh Flow HVAC website. And if you scroll down here to the bottom, I do have a very large FAQ system built for this test system for the sole purpose of programming the AI bot. So right now, notice that it was trained, and here's the date that it was trained on. If I wanted to, I can just simply click the refresh button, and it's going to go back out to the website in case the website changed, updated, you added some additional data. It's going to reread it, get rid of information, but it's basically going to refresh itself, go out, read the data, and then become intelligent about the data that you already have in there currently. Now, this is great. This is the first step that you need to do. Now, out of all of this, if you find out that you want to manually add some FAQs or questions and answers, you can come here to the bottom and add this right here, add in a question and answer to the AI bot's sort of intelligence. But from here, what we can do is, rather than going through the website and going through this widget right here, you can just simply go through and just see what the AI bot would do. Now, one of the things I want to make sure I do before we go to trial is go to configure intents. If you do plan on having the appointment booking area done, you need to turn this on first. This is disabled by default. If you click on this, it will give you a list of options here. And this one, I have an estimate calendar and a service calendar. So whichever one you want, whichever calendar is going to be booking appointments for you for this, you need to make sure you turn that on and select it. Okay. Now, I think for the most part, you know, for just general businesses, that this support, general question and answer, edit prompt, and so forth are sufficient. So right here, who is the bot, programming it, and things like that. I think Highlevel's done a great job, even though there are a couple of other templates that you can select from here. But right now, one of the things about the appointment booking bot is, please be careful. If you're using the live chat bot on your site and you want to include the AI system with it, the live chat bot doesn't know who you are. When you're communicating, when you communicate with the live chat, and let's just see if this is, so I think this already remembers my name from the other one, but basically in the live chat, it doesn't ask you your name, your phone number, or the message, like your conventional chat bot. It just simply, how can we help you? Now, when it does that, it doesn't know your phone number, your name, it doesn't know anything. So before it books an appointment, you have to be able to program the AI bot to ask those questions, or even to ask other questions. To do that, you want to go ahead and click on this little edit prompt button right here. And when you come down here to the bottom, you want to make sure where it says conversation flow, you want to add all the questions that you want the bot to ask and collect from the person to update the contact record before you actually book the appointment. So if you highlight over this, the bot will ask these questions before booking an appointment or sending to the booking link. Now, the booking link itself, don't worry about that. If you're using a third party, the booking link will most likely ask for your name, phone number, all that other kinds of stuff. However, if you want to book an appointment here, you have to ask this information. Otherwise, it'll book an appointment, but it'll be meaningless because it'll have no name, no information, no contact, which means none of your appointment booking workflows and your appointment reminder workflows will function. So please make sure you add this. And I've just got in here, if you take a look, what is your first name? Answer, what is your last name, answer, email address, phone number, and then the bot automatically updates the contact record based upon the responses, which is perfect. And then when it books the appointment, then it has everything it needs. It can send out a text, it can send out an email and all that other stuff, and you're good to go. Now that you've done that, you can come back to bot trial and say, let's just say my heat is not working. So this is where you can test it, and I'm not a very good typist, so I misspelled it. Hey, it sounds like you're dealing with heating issues. Have you noticed any strange noises? No strange noises, but not working. So, and again, if you're doing the testing here, you can do this testing without any charges. Now, typically, you do know that when the AI bot responds, it does charge, and those charges are located here. So you can pay for the basic current plan, or you can upgrade for your particular clients. So $49 a month, just flat out plan. And this is if they're really doing a lot of business with communicating with clients over all of these channels. Again, if they're doing social media, website chat, live chat, the SMS, which is like missed call, text back, things like that, all of that stuff can be embodied with just this plan. With the bot trial, notice, got it. Sounds like you have a heating issue. How about we get you set up an appointment? What is your first name? Boom, that right there. Do you see what it is? And two things it already said, hey, sounds like you got a problem. Let's book an appointment. And now it's going to get your first name, your last name, and so forth, all the information that we have in there. And then it's going to go ahead and book an appointment. So that right there is pretty cool. Now, I like using this conversation AI here whenever you really want dynamic conversations, okay? If you ever have a client or if you ever have a need where you have very focused, direct questions, pre-qualifying questions, and I've seen this a lot with roofing companies and solar companies and things like that where they have to ask, is your house in direct sunlight? Is things like that. So you have to ask pre-qualifying questions because if not, you're going to be wasting your time trying to send somebody out there. Now, if you want to ask pre-qualifying questions, then you need to use the workflow of the conversation AI feature action inside of the workflow. I'm not going to cover that here, but I have a whole other conversation AI where I go over how to do that. It's another video on my YouTube channel. But this right here is the very basics for just getting conversation AI set up. Boom, get it trained, get it programmed. And this right here can be very good in just responding. And this right here can help you sell AI services to small businesses and help them. Now, a couple of other settings real quick here. I recommend if you're going to be using an AI system on a website, don't pretend like it's a human. Don't. Notice over here, if we take a look at this, I'm going to try to refresh this and see if I get the bubble back again here. So if I get this thing, notice down here in the bottom, it says, welcome to, how can we help you? So right now, hello, my name is Echo. I am your AI assistant. So right now, the people, when they go to this, they already know I'm your AI assistant. This is not live. Now, if you do that, one of the things you can do that's beneficial for you is you can adjust the time frames by which the AI bot communicates. Now, if you want to pretend like it's a human, then down here in the settings for this autopilot mode, this thing right here is when you say wait time before responding, I've got it set to 3 seconds. Now, in 3 seconds, most people aren't going to be able to type the message and respond within 3 seconds, but AI can do that quickly. So if you can, you could reduce this wait time between responding to as quickly as the AI can actually respond. But if it's a human, you may want to put this to something like 50 seconds or even go to 2 minutes before response. If you want to make it seem a bit more human, like a human has to think about it, a human has to type, things like that. But if you're dealing with an AI system, just don't pretend. People are cool with that, I believe, that if you tell them it's an AI system, then they know that it's going to be responded to right away. And that's even going to be more beneficial because people get their answers faster, especially if your AI system is trained well. This right here, the wait time before responses. Again, I'm just going to go back to 3 seconds on this one. Maximum responses to send. How much communication back and forth do you want before the AI bot just says no more communication? Now, if you notice in the bot training, it only took about 2 tries, 2, maybe 3, and then the bot's like, hey, let's get you scheduled for an appointment. Boom. That was all it took. But it would just go to a maximum of whatever you configure here. Keep in mind, every message that's sent by the AI bot, you will get charged for. Now, right here, send the bot to sleep after so many hours. So if there's no activity in 2 hours, then the bot just goes to sleep. It doesn't keep track of the conversation and stuff like that. So guys, I hope you found this useful. This is just real quick, basic to the point, how to get this stuff configured, why you would use this versus the workflow AI. And again, hopefully you got something from this. If you're still looking, haven't signed up for the Go High Level platform and you're looking to get signed up, I do have a link in the description. It gives you 30 days free trial to get this stuff set up and start getting clients immediately. If you have not subscribed to my channel, hook a brother up. Come on, subscribe to my channel. I appreciate your support. And please, the video, give it a comment because YouTube loves it whenever users do that. It really pushes my videos up and makes my channel just more popular. Guys, thanks so much for your support and have a great day. Bye-bye.